So today, I think we need to put this old Massey Ferguson to work. So I got a thumb on it, so that's nice. So now I can pick up these stumps. I got a pile of them there. And basically, I want to work my way down through there. And way, way, way down there, there's actually a road on the property, and it connects back up to the main road. And what I want to do is have a road here so my driveway will come in from in behind me and I can circle out. So I'm just going to work on popping all these stumps out, and then there's some over there of what will be yard one day. So yeah. So basically, we're just going to start digging some stumps. If we can get this girl to start. Help my cold starting situation today. We got us a heater blowing right into the intake. So we'll see if that helps. Everybody says use ether, and when I do, this thing will not hit off ether. I don't know what its deal is. So anyways, let's see how she starts. Start with this one and work my way down. You can see them down through there. that last one there was a lot bigger than I thought it was. Well, it was a hardwood too, but now we got those two. Well, there's actually three there, so I might try and get all them. A little bit colder today, so basically I want to get that one there out and that one right there out. So that's all I have planned to do this evening because it's cold and that's probably all I'm gonna feel like doing. So let's get to it. Okay, so before I dig out any more stumps, I want to start using this smaller bucket here. So I think it'll be a little easier to dig with, and should be easier on the machine too. So in order to use this one, I mentioned it was missing one tooth, and these old teeth have a lot of wear. Here's comparison with a new one. So you can see there. I didn't realize how wore down they actually was, but pretty wore out. So we're going to put these new teeth on. But before I do that, I got a little wild when I was cutting them off with the grinder and got into these shanks a little bit. So I'm just going to run a weld over top of those. Run it back down smooth, and we'll pop these new teeth on and weld them on. Okay, so welds turned out pretty decent on this guy. So there's different ways you can mount these teeth on here. At least all the ones I've done, I always just weld the top and the bottom of it. And then when you got to replace it, you got to grind down the welds. Anyways, so I guess we will come back in a couple days and see how this bucket digs. This grease fitting under here wasn't wanting to take grease the other day. So let me see if it'll take it without the pin in here. If not, I'll put a new fitting in it. Nope. Thing still won't take any. Guess what it is? All that really old grease gets built up in there and for whatever reason gets really hard, so. Got a new grease fitting. Let's see if we can't get this guy back in here. Maybe not. I'll find a little piece of wire or something that I can run through there and we'll be good. Hey, there we go. All right. We got to knock loose now. Pretty warm out today, so we're gonna try at least for this little group of three right here. So let's get over here and get to it. Thank you. Yeah, this is looking pretty good. So that little bucket does a lot better digging them out. So now I'm gonna get this double stump here, and I could work my way on down this road, but I think I'm gonna go ahead and get all these out of the back here. So let's get to it. Alright, well that pretty much wraps up this video. So, you guys have a good day.